That here again, as the team that he's bringing to this tournament here is considered to be like kind of standard in a way, yeah, this specific combination of the five Pokemon that we're seeing here on his side, the Togedemaru, the Tapu Fini, Arcanine, Gardevoir, and Celesteela, was also used by multiple players, including for example Will Tansley or Till Boehmer at the World Championships. Those two though opted to go with a Snorlax as their last Pokemon. Sanvi and Matthias Sigudolski, two more players who opted for the exact same composition. But after the Worlds, it seemed like the Mandibuzz was getting some hype in that slot. So yeah, Alex is using that team that Clément probably has heard about at least a little bit before. So he might have an idea of what he wants to do in this battle. But yeah, his team on the other hand is a little bit more unorthodox, so Alex probably has never played against these exact six Pokémon.
Yeah, and just to go over Clément's Pokemon here, so we've got the Bravery, we've got the Porygon2, the Gastrodon, Arcanine, Cortana, and Tapu Lele. Very interesting collection of Pokemon here for Clément, and you know he's got that Bravery that is so good because of the Defiant ability that it has. It kind of puts Alex off bringing that Arcanine, doesn't want to activate the Defiant ability and give that Bravery an attack boost. If you know, you can help it. So that's one thing that Clément has kind of got going for him going into this first match. And Alex will, like you say, he doesn't take risks or anything like that. So he will play this very cautiously. He'll probably do a bit of an information game here, gather as much information as he can in this game, and then see where he can capitalize on going into the other matches to try and just take this set.
Yes, definitely. One of the Pokemon that Alex is using on his team is that Mandibuzz, and a lot of players have struggled to take down the pretty common Mandibuzz and Togedemaru combination that at some points you establish in the game. But Clément has the Tapu Lele on his team, so he has some ways to block the fake out coming out from the Togedemaru and also do lots of damage to the Mandibuzz. So cleverly Alex decides to opt to lead with that Tapu Fini to raise Mandibuzz's special defense with the Misty Seed right on turn 1, so Mandibuzz can take potential attacks from Tapu Lele later in the game a little bit better.
Yeah, and as we see Clément, he does lead out with that Bravery and the Cortana, so kind of trying to bait the Arcanine in on that slot from Alex's side of the field, and Alex leading off, like you say, with that Mandibuzz, getting that early Misty Seed boost for that special defensive boost there, and he's got the Tapu Fini next to it. So, you know, Alex is in a nice position now. What do you think he's going to go for? Maybe a Tailwind?
Yeah, he could really use the Tailwind support here. Since his team, with potentially maybe the Garchomp in the back, we don't really know, of course. But outpacing that Cortana is always good, because if you're opting to go with the team that Alex has chosen here, usually you don't have a Pokemon that can outspeed Cortana. So if that's maybe an offensive like Sword Dance or whatever variant, then you always want to be able to yeah, have some means to check that.
And we see Alex switch out that Tapu Fini in preparation for that Leaf Blade that comes out from the Cortana, goes straight into the Celesteela, and Mandibuzz going for that Tailwind on Alex's side of the field. Bravery on Clément's side of the field matching that Tailwind, so keeping up to par with the speed control here from Alex's side of the field.
Yeah, really interesting seeing the interaction in terms of speed between the Mandibuzz and the Bravery, as the Mandibuzz of Alex actually outpacing the Bravery of Clément. And usually Bravery is a Pokémon that you would train to be like as fast as possible, whereas Mandibuzz usually tries to be very bulky. However, I think it's a trend coming over from Japan to use a very fast Mandibuzz, because if you can outpace, for example, Arcanine of your opponent, then that can be very, very beneficial. Being able to roost before they get to attack you, maybe throw out some foul plays and maybe KO them before they can attack you, or some option that a couple of trainers have opted to very recently is that Snarl. So if you can outpace Tapu Fini and Snarl them before they can attack you, then you take even less damage considering that you also have that Misty Seed.
Yeah, we do see Clément switch out that Bravery and bring in Arcanine now to get that intimidate off, importantly onto probably the Celesteela here. And we're going to go into Cortana just detecting, probably wary of a flamethrower maybe from that Celesteela. Mandibuzz going for a foul play into that Arcanine slot, going to do some nice damage there. And Celesteela following up with a heavy slam, doubling into that slot.
Yeah, very solid play here by Alex. While, yeah, Arcanine was a switch in that can take that combination of foul play and heavy slam. Yeah, he identified that Cortana of Clermont was under a lot of pressure since Celesteela potentially could have that flamethrower attack and also just foul play from Mandibuzz doing so much damage due to Cortana's high attack stat. And Clermont really might need that Cortana to deal with Alex's Tapu Fini later on in the game. So yeah, very clever identifying that and getting off a lot of damage on that Arcanine. And now, since we have seen that this Mandibuzz from Alex is probably a little faster, and seeing how much damage Foul Play was able to do to Arcanine, Clermont actually has to be a little bit worried that maybe if Mandibuzz can outpace his Arcanine here, yeah, he could go down in one hit, and then Celesteela is also staring out at that Cortana with a potential flamethrower. So Clermont really needs to make a choice here, whether he wants to risk that. But on the other hand, if he has a faster Arcanine, getting off Flablitz to do a lot of damage and then also potentially activating his own Berry in the process would make him take that foul play. So this is a very important turn here for Clermont's Arcanine, I think.
As we see Clermont switch out the Cortana for that Bravery, bringing it back in here, and Alex switching out to the Garchomp. Arcanine just opting to protect there. We see another foul play come out from the Mandibuzz into the protect of the Arcanine, and we are into our next turn.
Yeah, and Garchomp coming in on Alex's side, really, really anticipating this Cortana to switch out, I think, because Celesteela was in a prime position to deal with the Cortana. But also he did want to ensure that his Celesteela doesn't take a lot of damage from that Arcanine's Flabbit, since as we were saying, Alex really trying to play it as cautiously as possible sometimes. He didn't want to risk this Arcanine being the very, very fast variant. So he brings in Garchomp, so Arcanine would take a ton of recoil damage due to Rough Skin. And now he also got his Garchomp into a prime position, so now Garchomp can deal with Arcanine, and Garchomp will definitely outpace.
Yeah, and Clermont want to preserve that Arcanine for later in the game, brings in the Gastrodon for that slot. We see Garchomp on Alex's side go for a Rock Slide, doing big damage to Bravery. Mandibuzz following up with a foul play, outspeeding that Bravery as we saw previous turns, doing big damage, but it does hang on, allowing Bravery to go for a Brave Bird into
the Mandibuzz, probably.
Into the Mandibuzz slot and doing heavy damage, but it is going to go down to the recoil there.
Yeah, and we've seen this Mandibuzz is kind of fast. So now Tailwind has petered out, but since both of the trainers set it up at the same time, it doesn't really do anything. But now Mandibuzz, I think, could be a real problem here for Clermont if he doesn't have something like maybe Toxic on that Gastrodon. Since one problem that he runs into is, if Mandibuzz carries Roost and outpaces his Pokémon, Mandibuzz is just gonna go and Roost off all the damage, and then he has to start all over again. And now he invested quite a bit with his Bravery, taking out his Pokémon in the process with that Brave Bird. Maybe that was actually calculated. Thinking that, hey, if Bravery goes down, I get to switch into whatever I want. But he did not opt to bring the Tapu Lele into this game. I think now Tapu Lele would probably be a nice switch in, threatening both the Mandibuzz and the Garchomp with Fairy-type attacks. But he has to rely on Cortana to take him all the way here. Mandibuzz should be able to take any attack coming in from this Cortana. So, Alex might have put himself into a position where this Mandibuzz can actually just like stall out the game, and then he's the only one who can set up Tailwind at this point, since Bravery from Clermont was already knocked out. So if he can maybe set up Tailwind this turn and then roost off the damage in future turns, then it can be very, very difficult for Clermont to take out the Mandibuzz.
Yeah, definitely. And like with the roost as well from the Mandibuzz, because the Misty terrain is up, it will be immune to that Toxic if, you know, the Gastrodon decides to go for it. So that's really interesting here. But we do see Alex withdraw the Garchomp. He is going to bring back that Celesteela on that side of the field.
Yeah, there's not really anything that Clermont can do to punish this. We're seeing Smart Strike coming out into the Mandibuzz, so that should do a decent amount, but yeah, just fell short of knocking out the Mandibuzz. And Roost is a very good play here, in my opinion, because now, since he did not set up the Tailwind, the Mandibuzz is exactly in the right speed tier in a way that it wants to be, because it wants to be slower than Cortana when roosting, so that Sacred Sword is not super effective, since upon using Roost, it loses the flying type. And then also we've seen that Gastrodon's Ice Beam is not really able to do too much damage due to the fact that now it's not super effective anymore. Alex actually, it's probably clever for him to not set up Tailwind here and then maybe Roost for a couple more turns while Celesteela can either spread Leech Seed on the Gastrodon or really threaten out that Cortana with a potential flamethrower here.
Yeah, of course we haven't seen Celesteela reveal the flamethrower yet, but I guess Alex is probably wanting to try and preserve that for as long as possible, not reveal that until it's really necessary. Cortana on Clermont's side of the field has to feel threatened at this point, so whether we see it maybe go for a Detect here, Gastrodon go out for maybe, you know, try Scaldburn, or like we've mentioned before, possibly having Toxic for that Mandibuzz would be a good way to get around it. We do see Clamont go for a Detect with that Cartana to protect it. Mandibuzz again, like you mentioned, going for a Roost, kind of just make sure, and it is going to be sticking around for the rest of this match. And we will see what the Celesteela does, reveal Flamethrower into that Detect on the Cartana, and an Ice Beam from Clamont's Gastrodon into Mandibuzz. And because of the Rooster obviously taking away the flying type this turn, doing minimal damage.
Yeah, but at least now the Misty Terrain is over, so that duration is gone, and now Gastrodon at least has a chance to potentially getting the freeze on the Mandibuzz, which is probably what Clamont is fishing for at this point, because he realizes, okay, my Cartana is under pressure from both the Mandibuzz and the Celesteela. I only have Arcanine in the bag with kind of low health, which would probably go down to foul play, so I really need to, maybe Ice Beam, freeze the Mandibuzz, maybe get a critical hit or something, and then have Arcanine deal with the Celesteela. So now he thinks that he has to switch out into his Arcanine to preserve Cartana for later on. But yeah, if Alex read that and goes for a double up into that slot with Foul Play and Flamethrower, which I think is a play that he would be capable of doing, then yeah, Arcanine would already go down. Instead though, we're just seeing the Tailwind being set up.
Yeah, Tailwind from Mandibuzz, Alex making sure that he's got the speed control on his side of the field, and just a Flamethrower into that slot, which was the Cartana, now the Arcanine. Arcanine obviously a fire type as well, able to take that quite comfortably, and a Scald coming out from Clamont's Gastrodon, I guess fishing for a burn, but no burn this time, and see Celesteela is holding that leftovers item.
Yeah, and we did see a critical hit here from Celesteela's Flamethrower into that Arcanine, not activating any berry. Now we're not entirely sure whether that would already be in berry activation range, or if that's just like a little shy of it, but now that Arcanine definitely in KO range of Foul Play from the Mandibuzz. And I think there's not really any reason for Alex not to go for that, and also maybe just go for the Leech Seed on the Gastrodon to ensure that even if a burn happened on the Celesteela, Clamont really doesn't have any tools to take it out. So I think Alex really has maneuvered this very well with his two bulky Pokemon, the Mandibuzz and the Celesteela, just putting them into a position where Clamont couldn't really do too much to both of them. And yeah, both the Mandibuzz and the Celesteela also have some access to recovery, as we're seeing here, the Leech Seed and Leftovers on the Celesteela side, and of course Roost on Mandibuzz's side. And yeah, this game Clamont really just wasn't able to break through that recovering bulkiness. And I think, yeah, it's pretty safe to say that Alex won't like let this game slip off his hands here, because Celesteela's Flamethrower kind of has the Celesteela locked up, and then Gastrodon might take a little longer to take that down. But yeah, overall, Alex just in a very, very fantastic position here.
Yeah, he's played extremely well, and I think just showing how good Mandibuzz can be in these situations. You know, you had Bravery on Clamont's side of the field. It had the Tailwind there for its speed control, but nowhere near as bulky, doesn't have access to recovery. And I think now that Alex has got that Leech Seed off into the Gastrodon, it's really going to make it so difficult for Clamont to come back from, and we do see a forfeit. Alex is going to take game one.
Yeah, and Clamont probably has to realize that I think that Tabuleta is a very, very important member for his team composition here in battling against that Mandibuzz, because yeah, Mandibuzz is just so bulky with Roost, with the Misty Seed. He won't be able to prevent the Misty Seed from activating, of course, since Tapu Fini can always like either under speed or switch out and in. But just in general, having the Tabulele available to him, potentially Taunt is an option to shut down that Mandibuzz from using its support moves, and then Moonblast just to do a lot of damage. Of course, that would open him up a little more for the Celesteela even, and his last Pokemon, Porygon 2, doesn't fare too well against Celesteela either. But yeah, I think that Mandibuzz and Celesteela combination from Alex that we've seen played to such great extent in this game, is something that Clamont going into the second game will need to focus on, and on how to position himself in like a way that he can actually take out one of these Pokemon. Because in this game, I don't think there was any scenario where he had any access to landing a big hit on either of the two. So yeah, he really needs to come up with a way to do that.
Yeah, I think you're totally correct in what you're saying, and I think a big thing there was with Clamont, when he switched in the Arcanine, he took so much damage from it, and he kind of, looking at his team, he's only really got that as an answer for the Celesteela, so important for him to protect that, make sure he puts it into a good position where he can get that Celesteela out on the field at the same time and hit it with some big fire type attacks. unfortunately didn't do it this time. We saw like how important the speed was from the Mandibuzz and Alex's side of the field, being able to kind of pick up the KO before it was able to move. And like you say as well, I think the Tapu Lele here is going to be huge. Does have to be careful for that Celesteela, but I think you can position your Arcanine and play that well around on Clement's side of the field. It should kind of create some openings for Clement to kind of work that Tapu Lele into the team here.
Yes, I think so too, but I also do think that Alex is a player that's intelligent enough to realize that, hey, okay, that was not too difficult to position Mandibuzz and Celesteela next to each other and create that lockdown so that Clement couldn't really do too much damage. So he realizes, hey, what could my opponent even do to stop that from happening again? And Tapu Lele seems like such an obvious answer that you gotta imagine that Alex also is ready to battle with that. And with the Garchomp and the Tapu Fini that he brought to the first battle, I actually think that both of those are kind of valid in battling against the Tapu Lele as well. So yeah, Alex just going for the same Pokemon to lead up with, and I wouldn't be too surprised if he didn't change up his back Pokemon either, just because of how well this particularly selection worked in the first game.
Yeah, and interestingly here we see Clement, he's not going with that Bravery here, he's brought the Porygon 2 instead. You know, obviously not feeling like it got any mileage for what he wanted to do in that first game, wanting to change things up here. But the thing is, with Alex, it does have that Mandibuzz. It possibly has access to Taunt, which is a great way to shut down that Porygon 2. Arcanine here, Intimidate, it's not really doing anything on Clement's side of the field. It is threatened from that Tapu Fini from Alex, so I think he might want to kind of switch up his position, do you think, at this point?
Yeah, certainly. If he did bring the Tapu Lele, then maybe that's a point to bring it in now. Maybe he decided to bring it in the back so that he could override the Misty terrain with a Psychic terrain upon switching in. But Arcanine is a Pokemon that I think definitely needs to come in this matchup to deal with Celesteela and also intimidate the potential Garchomp. But up front, it just doesn't really do anything. And Clement, also realizing that, switches back into his Tapu Lele, just as we were expecting, getting the Psychic Surge activating. And yeah, now we'll have the Psychic terrain available to him.
The Moonblast coming out from Alex's Tapu Fini into that slot, into the Porygon 2 there, and a Taunt into that slot as well. So shutting down that potential Trick Room here. And we'll see the Porygon 2 just going for an Ice Beam into the Mandibuzz, trying to rack up some damage on that early on, and huge damage, a massive critical hit there for Clement, doing ridiculous amounts of damage to the Mandibuzz here and putting it in a really threatening position. Like you said, maybe switching in the Tapu Lele on Clement's side. What's the idea here? He's got it in now. You presume it might outspeed the Mandibuzz, and if it does, it's going to threaten a KO onto it this turn.
Yeah, very solid play here coming out from Ono, and now he put himself into that position that we were talking about previously. Like, this is the spot he needs to be in, because now he can make a read. Maybe the Mandibuzz could switch out, maybe Celesteela is coming in, but if he can catch that switch in and switch in into his Arcanine potentially, then he would have created a situation where he is able to take the knockout. He decided to go with the Dazzling Gleam, and that is not enough to knock out the Mandibuzz. Ooh, that could be huge here, as we're seeing Roost, and now the Mandibuzz, all of a sudden, it will be at about 50% of its health again. I'm still having that Misty Seed activated, so Thunderbolt actually coming out into the Celesteela, though. Nice play here coming out by Arnaud, and now, yeah, with that extra damage on both Pokemon, even though he failed to pick up the KO on the Mandibuzz, I still do think that he's in a fine position here with that Thunderbolt.
Yeah, revealing the Thunderbolt there and just seeing how much damage it did to the Celesteela. It's another way for Clement to deal with that Celesteela, which was the big threat in game one, you know, alongside the Mandibuzz. But as you say, he's really adapted his game plan now. He's got the Tapu Lele in a position where he's really threatening the Mandibuzz. Maybe he goes for a Moonblast this turn, and then the Porygon 2, that Celesteela, is definitely in Thunderbolt range.
Yeah, so once again, very nice switch up here. Bringing both the Tapu Lele and the Porygon 2, we were kind of a little bit doubting the Porygon 2, but it's been putting in so much work here. Yeah, thanks to the nice coverage it got, hitting the Celesteela for super effective damage. Thunderbolt, not something that we're seeing too often these days anymore, so probably something that Alex did not expect and that caught him a little bit off guard. But Clement is continuously playing well here. Now switching an Arcanine over the Tapu Lele because he knows that there's a potential for, yeah, Heavy Slam just landing into that slot. But in fact, we're just seeing a Protect from Celesteela, so Alex may be reading into that play. Yep, just going for another Roost, and I wouldn't be too surprised if this was just another Thunderbolt into the Celesteela.
Yeah, here we're going to see the Mandibuzz get that roost off, get its health back, and a Thunderbolt, like you say, Marcus, into that Protect on the Celesteela here. The Celesteela is pretty heavily threatened here, so you'd think Alex might want to adjust his board position. You know, he's not got the Tailwind up. We don't know if the Celesteela's speed would outspeed the Arcanine. Probably don't normally.
Yeah.
So you've got to imagine that Alex wants to preserve that Pokemon, maybe switch it in for the Tapu Fini that we've already seen. It's a nice switch in, but he's always got to be aware that there could be a Thunderbolt coming out
to that slot.
So it's a bit difficult, isn't it, for him to kind of maneuver around whether or not he has maybe the Garchomp like he did in game
one. I actually think Garchomp would be a pretty fine switch in here for the Celesteela, because one play that Claymore could make here was to just double up into the slot that just protected, go for, say, Flare Blitz and Thunderbolt to do massive damage, no matter what switch in here, but yeah, Garchomp would actually be able to take both of those attacks. So maybe Ice Beam and Flare Blitz could be something that Claymore might want to look into, but nope, he just, Alex decides to just straight up stay in with the Celesteela, maybe deciding that at that low HP, it's probably not really doing too much for me anymore anyway. Yeah, lets it go down and now gets off another attack with the Mandibuzz. And we now also do get confirmation that this Arcanine actually outspeeds Mandibuzz, so just another piece of information that both players can use here. While, we see another taunt, but Porygon doesn't really have any reason to not go for an attacking move here, since we probably can rule out at this point that it has something like Toxic, due to the fact that we've already seen Ice Beam and Thunderbolt being the coverage options of choice here for Claymore. This town maybe just a little bit preemptively to stop a potential Trick Room from going up or from recovering, or the Porygon from recovering at later points. Really, this game, Claymore has found himself into a position where he now already took one KO, and it looks like with the Tapu Lele in the back, if he can maneuver that around and position it well, then he can also really threaten the Mandibuzz here.
Yeah, and you know, there's not really too much that's threatening the Porygon too at this point on the stage. You know, it's so bulky of a Pokemon, it's going to be able to take a combination of attacks quite easily and just keep throwing out those Thunderbolts, those Ice Beams, and we are going to see Claymore switch up his board position here, bring out the Arcanine, bring back in that Tapu Lele to get control of the terrain again, activate that Psychic Surge, get the Psychic terrain on the field, and we're going to go for a Moonblast from Alex's Tapu Fini into the Porygon 2, trying to chip it down again, doing really good damage, and Mandibuzz going for a Tailwind here.
Yeah, really well played here by Alex, identifying that Porygon's only option to stay around in this battle would be to go for a Recover this turn, because with Thunderbolt being a two-hit knockout from the HP that Porygon was left with, Recover could have messed that plan up, but going for the Taunt the previous turn and now setting up Tailwind this turn makes it so that now Porygon, if it wants to stay in this battle, has to switch out now, but it's already at such low HP that Alex probably can find the KO once Porygon comes back in. So Claymore now has to make a choice whether he wants to keep Porygon 2 around or just like say go for another Thunderbolt, but that Thunderbolt did so much damage on the Tapu Fini, so the download boost really coming in clutch here for that Porygon since the very beginning of the game. Usually Porygon known to be more supportive Pokemon, but doing so much damage with the coverage options that he had, hitting all three Pokemon that we've seen from Alex in this battle for super effective damage. Claymore also wants to keep that in the bag for him.
Yeah, preserving that Porygon 2 for later on in the game, getting rid of that Taunt, resetting it for when it comes back in, bringing the Arcanine in that slot. Tapu Fini going for a Moonblast into the Tapu Lele this time, Alex predicting that the Porygon 2 switch out. We do see a Moonblast from the opposing Tapu Lele into Alex's Mandibuzz, but Mandibuzz, because of that boost that it got earlier on, being able to take that, and Alex predicting the attack into that slot, going for a roost to get back that damage.
Yeah, and actually the Tapu Lele outpacing the Mandibuzz despite that Tailwind being up on Alex's side, so we're pretty safe to assume that this is a choice Scarf Tapu Lele, which is also why he went for the Dazzling Gleam, which is not a move that's seen too often on Tapu Lele outside of Choice Scarf or Choice Specs. And then also the fact that he switched out after he realized, that Mandibuzz can just roost on and Dazzling Gleam is not going to do enough damage to knock it out. So he switched out Tapu Lele, brought it back in now, so he could lock into Moonblast. But yeah, with Mandibuzz's bulk and Roost and Misty Seed, like that combination just still seems so difficult for him to break down. And now due to the Tailwind and the fact that we've seen that this Tapu Lele is choice locked, he can't even protect this turn. So he really has to potentially take a Moonblast, and that is what we're seeing. So Tapu Lele goes down here, and once again, Will Clément have enough answers for that Mandibuzz is the question.
That's the thing, and Alex has just taken his opportunities to get those roosts off when he could, throwing out a big foul play into that Arcanine, doing about 50% damage. Arcanine retaliating with a Flare Blitz into the Mandibuzz and picking up the burn, which is huge this turn.
I really needed to get that burn, not only to chip away on that Mandibuzz, but also to lower foul play's power here. Once again, that Arcanine not quite activating any sort of item here. It depends on whether a Moonblast from what we assume to be a Choice Specs Tapu Fini based on the damage on Clément's Tapu Lele, if that is enough to even knock out Arcanine at this point. But we see Cartana switch in for Clément, and that is exactly the Pokémon that he needs in this situation. Because Cartana, outside of Tailwind at least, will be able to outpace and KO both the Mandibuzz and the Tapu Fini from where we are in terms of their health at the moment. I'm saying that because if Mandibuzz decides to go for another Roost, then that option is gone again for Clément. But yeah, this turn really also pretty important, I guess, because whether Cartana is going to protect you or not on the last turn of Tailwind here for Alex, it can mean the difference of Mandibuzz being at like a healthy amount of HP if it decides to go for the Roost here on the Protect, or Mandibuzz just being like out of the picture entirely. So
we see the Detect come out from Clément's Cartana this turn, and a Protect from Arcanine stalling out this Tailwind, I presume here, as we see the Tapu Fini go for another Moonblast into the Cartana, and a foul play from the Mandibuzz, not going for a Roost this turn.
Yeah, so he gets that right, and Clément has to be very happy with how this worked out, because now Tailwind is petered out, and we've seen Arcanine outpace Mandibuzz previously. So just a Flare Blitz into the Mandibuzz and a Leaf Blade into the Tapu Fini should be enough to KO both of those Pokémon. And Mandibuzz usually do not carry Protect, and the Tapu Fini, being Choice Specs, also probably won't have access to Protect this turn. So it looks like Clément actually put himself into a position where he just can take a guaranteed knockout this turn, and then with his Cartana, potentially also getting the Beast Boost, boosting his attack stat, it looks like he's in a position to just steamroll the game here. And really well played. I think that burn might have definitely helped him, because without that, and Alex probably going for some more roosts, it would have been super tough to knock out the Mandibuzz. But now he has that option, and we'll see if Alex can come up with some resources to prevent that from happening, but it looks very grim.
As we see Alex switch out his Tapu Fini for later in the game, bringing in the Garchomp on that slot. We are going to see Cartana go for a Leaf Blade into the Garchomp. It does a huge damage, taking Garchomp down, a critical hit as well. Rough Skin damage onto the Cartana, just chipping away at that, and a Flare Blitz from Arcanine, which you presume will be into the Mandibuzz to pick up the KO here.
And is it enough? It gets the KO, yes. So Clément will be able to most likely take this game. Now we might also get confirmation on the item on Arcanine. Finally, this very Ferox. You really always want to get that berry activating, but yeah, you gotta be below 25% of its health. And in the first game, that just didn't happen. But now, Arcanine also looking strong here. Tapu Fini has to come in for Alex. Yeah, he probably would have preferred to bring in something else. Maybe that Arcanine that he could look for the third game that will most likely be going into now. Clément, I don't know, really coming through with some interesting adaptions, bringing both the Tavalele and the Porygon 2. We doubted the Porygon 2 for a little bit, but that was certainly probably the winning Pokémon, really, as it did even more than the Tapu Lele. Due to the fact that Tapu Lele is Choice Scarf, it's also limiting his options a little bit. Also bringing the Porygon made a lot of sense here, and Alex, after a pretty calm and very calculated first game, now really has to come up with a plan for what he wants to do in the third game.
Yeah, I think you're right in what the Porygon 2 has been so big here, as we see Clément go for a Protect with the Arcanine here. Leaf Blade coming out from the Cartana into the Garchomp. This will pick up the KO, and Cartana will get a Beast Boost from this KO. Let's see what Alex's Tapu Fini locked itself into. As we say, it has got that Choice Specs item. Beast Boost on Cartana, raising that attack stat, and a Muddy Water coming out. But you've got to think that it's a bit too late for Alex. Maybe he just plays on and fishes for information.
Yeah, maybe fishing for a critical hit or some accuracy drop, but even then we would have Smart Strike, which is able to bypass that. So this is second game going to Clément, and now Alex, you can see it in his face. This is not what he expected. I think after the first game he was, not overly confident, but he had pretty good reason to, well, anticipate that in the second game he would have the tools. He had the Mana Buzz and Celesteela combination. And sometimes, which a couple of these very bulky Pokemon, it's just a question of, hey, does your opponent have an answer to deal with them, yes or no? In the first game, the answer was just no. Like, Claymore just couldn't deal with them. And so, yeah, Alex could be like, hey, okay, I might just do the same thing again the second game. And yeah, for a decent while, it looked like, hey, that could work. But with the adaptions that Clermont made, with that Porygon being so offensive after, or being such an offensive threat after the download boost, yeah, he was really able to break through that bulky core of Alex. And now, yeah, in the third game, anything could happen, really.
Yeah, and that's it. I think the big thing that kind of Clermont kind of identified going into that game was, I need ways to deal with the Celesteela. It just was so problematic for him in that first game, and we saw how well Alex plays it. But bringing that Porygon too, such a surprise for us, I think, was the damage that it did. It got a bit lucky in that first turn with the critical hit into the Mana Budge. But then we saw the Thunderbolt damage onto the Celesteela and really kind of pinned it in a position where Alex was kind of either forced to switch it out and allow something to you know, for Clermont to either make a read and get a big advantage there or just allow it to go down and lose it for the rest of the match. So Alex needs to really kind of adapt his game plan here a little bit, I think. Maybe, you know, one thing you could look at bringing maybe to deal with that T-Bolt threat from the Porygon 2 is the Togedemaru, maybe.
Yes.
It provides fake out support as well.
Certainly.
It will help the Mana Buzz, obviously it protects the Mana Buzz from those Thunderbolts. It helps it set up the Tailwind and things like that. But then it's also threatened from things like Cortana as well.
Yeah, usually though, yeah, Togedemaru is a Pokemon that itself is just like pretty weak. It has the supporting cast of Fake Out and Encore going for it, and as well, of course, the incredibly good ability in Lightning Rod. But usually you want to use that to lock out like Tapu Koko's, for example. Mm-hmm. So if you bring Togedemaru, you also put yourself into a position where you won't have enough, or you won't have as much offensive power as with some of these other Pokemon. And I think one thing that he would need against that Porygon 2 is either offensive power or like disruption with like status moves. So Encore could probably help him, and also the taunt from the Mana Buzz. But something that I wanted to stress on is that I think Celesteela has a way better, or like has a very important role here in this third game. Because with Leech Seed, it's one of the few things that can stick around with Porygon and just recovering some health here and there between Leftovers and Leech Seed, and also chipping down the Porygon, while also really kind of walling the Tabo Lele, which was the other Pokemon that we identified with, that could deal with the Mana Buzz. So, yeah, Alex coming up with this lead of Tapu Fini and Celesteela, and now Clermont once again is the one who's like, kind of like, in a position where he could essentially like lose the game on the first turn. I think Alex could potentially also lose it, because, I mean, over-exaggerating a little bit, but both Cortana and Tapu Fini are at the potential of being knocked out, so it's like two cowboys staring each other down, who's gonna like pull the trigger first. But we're seeing the Togedemaru, as you mentioned here, coming in for Alex.
Do see Clermont switch out that Porygon 2 to the Tapu Lele to change the terrain, get it back into his favor. We are gonna see the Cortana just go for a detect here. It is threatened from that potential flamethrower from the Celesteela, and we do see a Leech Seed onto that Tapu Lele slot. So starting off, like you were saying, with that Leech Seed, getting those Leech Seeds, important Leech Seeds off.
Yeah, so Alex stayed very cool there, I think. He knew, hey, this Cortana is under so much pressure. I don't want to risk losing my Tapu Fini, so I'm gonna switch in Togedemaru to also protect the Celesteela from a potential Thunderbolt. So there wasn't really too much that Clermont could have done to punish this play, except for like a crazy read with Sacred Sword into the Tapu Fini, fishing for the Togedemaru switch in, but he had really no way of knowing whether Alex would now switch up the Pokemon he selected. And now, the Tapu Lele being switching against two steel types, usually not the position you want to be in. However, in this particular instance now, it also blocks the fake out from the Togedemaru. So now, Tapu Lele probably wants to leave the field right away, because we've also had confirmation that this is a Choice Scarf variant. So Celesteela could just go for a Heavy Slam into that slot without really fearing anything. So yeah, Clermont decides to switch out and bring in the Arcanine. That on the other hand is a Pokemon that you want to have in against two steel types.
Yeah, definitely, 100%. You've got the Arcanine coming in, getting that important Intimidate off onto the Togedemaru and the Celesteela. Going to see Alex switch out his Togedemaru back into the Tapu Fini, get the terrain back in his favor this turn. And we'll see what this Cortana goes for, because it is in a threatened position. It can threaten on that side of the field as well. It does go for the Sacred Sword into the Tapafini, which it's able to take quite easily.
Yeah.
And a Flamethrower coming out from Celesteela onto the Cortana, which is going to be super effective. And, ooh, reveals the Focus Sash on Clement's Cortana.
Yeah, I think that's definitely one of those plays that you can really identify Alex being, yeah, the favorite in this matchup, I would say, but also just being such a good player overall, really identifying that, hey, this Celesteela at the moment is the one Pokemon that is in a safe spot. His Cortana, he might get a little bit too greedy here, thinking that, oh, I can just go for the Sacred Sword, I'm blocking the fake out, so this Takedomaru can't really do too much, so hey, I'm going to go for that Sacred Sword. Instead, switching out into the Tapu Fini into the Cortana, very risky in a way, but also anticipating the Arcanine to come in. So yeah, just really looking forward, or like thinking in advance, thinking ahead, and Alex now having the Tapu Fini in. So now again, Clement really kind of wants to keep his Cortana in here, but if he does that, then yeah, this is what we might see here. Alex switching out the Tapu Fini and probably attacking the Cortana again with his Celesteela. No, instead though, going for the Perfect, okay? Because I thought that might have been an opportunity to like switch in his Arcanine, but yeah, we already see all four Pokemon revealed by Alex now that the Garchomp comes in. So yeah, he doesn't have that Arcanine. No. However, another thing that he uses to knock out the Cortana, another really cool play, switching in the Garchomp with its ability Rough Skin to knock out the last HP of health that was left on the Cortana.
Really smart play there from Alex, you know, knowing that the Cortana wants to target into that Tapu Fini slot and, you know, not wanting to risk Flare Blitz from the Arcanine into Celesteela protecting it here, but knowing that the Rough Skin damage is going to be enough to take that Cortana down. It was on its sash, and that's what Alex managed to do, playing it very well here. We see Clement bring in that Tapu Lele, get this psychic terrain back up, but the Garchomp now is heavily threatened from that Tapu Lele. We have seen that it is scarfed, but again, at the same time, the Celesteela is kind of protecting it, but the Arcanine heavily threatens the Celesteela in the same kind of vein here.
Yeah, so we have one of those like cross situations where one Pokemon is threatening one Pokemon on the other side respectively, but it really depends on what Pokemon is targeting where, because Arcanine probably might not be able to knock out this Celesteela in one hit with a Flare Blitz. So Clement could commit here and double up into that Celesteela, but that would open himself up for a play where Garchomp just go for an offensive move and knocks out Arcanine, and then Celesteela knocks out the Tapu Lele. So yeah, this could be a big turn, and knowing Alex, he probably wants to play it like safe and cautiously, but we'll see here.
As he does switch out that Garchomp, saving it for later on, he brings in the Tapu Fini to change the terrain, get rid of that psychic terrain, get rid of the boost for the Tapu Lele, and we will see what the Tapu Lele goes for. A Moonblast into that. You've got to imagine the Garchomp slot, which is now that Tapu Fini doing good damage. And Arcanine following up with a Flare Blitz into Celesteela. It's got to be, yes,
yeah, so
it
this
is.
Should be able to survive, yeah, because Alex is a player that knows, hey, if I'm taking this Flare Blitz, which is pretty likely to come out from that Arcanine, then yeah, he wouldn't allow that unless Celesteela is built in a way that it can take this attack. And now he gets off that big heavy slam, knocking out the Tapu Lele. So once again, just really Alex finding the resources to switch something in and then also go for the offensive move with his Celesteela. Interestingly enough, we've already seen that happen, the same pattern against the Cortana. And now it seems like in this third game, he really got a better read on his opponent and identifies on where his opponent switches and where his opponent wants to get off that big those big attacks. And now he was able to punish those instances twice and is rewarded by being up two Pokemon. So yeah, he has all four of his Pokemon left while his opponent is down to his last two. However, one of those is that Porygon. And we've talked about it a bit, but Porygon seems to be one way for Clement to maybe bring this back. Since this time we're not seeing the Mandibuzz, so there's no taunt in this game potentially on Alex's side. So if Clement can maybe find some of the KOs here early on, this might just end the game right here, because Tapu Fini outpacing Arcanine and one hit KOing it with the Scald here.
Yeah.
So
and we see the Celesteela there getting the Leech Seed off onto the Porygon 2. Try attack coming out from the Porygon 2 into the Tapu Fini.
Wait. What's that Porygon's moveset? We've already seen Ice Beam and Thunderbolt. Now also try attack. That's pretty interesting. So maybe this Porygon in fact is actually a little bit more offensive deeply trained, which is why it's doing so much damage. But Tri-Tech, that would be a way around the Lightning Rod from Togenomaru. But now, since Arcanine went down, the Celesteela getting off the Leech Seed, and now Togenomaru can just go for like Fake Out, and then Porygon will take even more damage from the Leech Seed, and then Encore potentially to lock the Porygon into Tri-Attack. And we'll see a slow and steady leeching away the last HP from this Porygon.
Yeah, and Alex has just played this so well, you know. He's put himself into a really good position. He's not taking any risks that he didn't need to. He's just taking the opportunities that he's had. Each time here we see him switch out that Celesteela, bringing in the Garchomp, going for a Fake Out with the Togedemaru. Will flinch the Porygon to this turn, making it unable to attack, and the Garchomp taking full advantage of that Leech Seed recovery.
Yeah, and really just bringing out his Garchomp. You gotta imagine that this is potentially the Z move here to end the game alongside maybe a Zing Zap from this Togedemaru. And Clément, he came pretty close, way closer than it looked like he might come after how the first game went. In the end, it looks like his lone Porygon 2 probably a little too lonely. We're seeing the Zing Zap by Togenomaru coming out here, actually outspeeding the Garchomp, which is also some interesting information, but coming a little too late. And this is the very first Z move, I think, that we're getting to see on stream here in the third game only at the Bilbao Special Championships here. But both players already shaking hands, and this Tectonic Rage is coming out from Garchomp into the Porygon 2. And if that isn't enough to knock it out, then there's still the Leech Seed damage. And Alex Gomez emerges victorious here over Clément Arnaud in this very first round of the Swiss at the Bilbao Special Championships. And